There is a given time for everything and a time for every happening under heaven. My dear friends, the teacher teaches us that. But rather, there is a time for everything, but there is no time for your relationship with Jesus. It can never be in a flux. It can never change. It has to be perpetual. It has to be strong and steady all the time. If that thing waves, if your relationship waves, there won't be any meaning in your life. That's exactly in Caesarea Philippi when Jesus was going with the disciples. It's a pagan land, half pagan, half Jews. There he asked, "Who do people say that I am? I am." And people have their own ideas, own notions and opinions. Those things will be in flux. Those things will change. But then the Lord is asking them, who am I to you? Who do you say that I am? That's the most profound, important question that you should ask. Who is Jesus to me? My dear friends, all the other things will pass. Everything will change. Impermanent. So only permanent thing is Jesus and his love. Isaiah chapter 54 verse 10, it is said, "The sky will fade, earth will shake, but his love will be the same always." And his word will never change. Even the sun and the moon changes. Even the earth shakes. His word will never change, the gospel says. Jesus is the same yesterday, today and tomorrow. Letter to Hebrews prophets. That's exactly should be our foundation. Everything will change. Everything, for everything there is a time. So don't get stuck in one incident. It will change. That's what the teacher says. A time for giving birth, a time for dying, a time for planting, time for uprooting, a time for killing, time for healing, time for knocking down, and time for building, a time for tears, and time for laughter, a time for mourning, a time for dancing, a time for throwing stones, a time for gathering stones, a time for embracing, time to refrain from embracing, a time for searching, a time for losing, a time for keeping, a time for throwing away, a time for tearing, a time for sowing, a time to be silent, and a time to speak. See, everything will change. So if you hold on to one incident, normally, human nature is such that we hold on to the painful part, the broken part. Normally, we keep in our mind all the sad memories, isn't it? The sad memories will follow us happy memory. The happy and sad will both in rotation. It changes. But then our nature, we all remember, harbor the grudges, the painful incidents. Remember that will also change. And we sometimes are scared to laugh too much, smile too much. The normally conservative believers, they think that if we laugh too much, we will cry soon. And then we are scared to laugh also. How much we are engrossed with the pain? No, it will change. The whole scenario should change. That's exactly where Jesus is saying, I have to suffer. I have to suffer. I have to be crucified, scourged, beaten. But then remember, the third day I will be raised again. Resurrection will follow. I'll be suffering death and resurrection. So you can't take away the suffering part from resurrection. and resurrection from the suffering part. It's all are joined, interconnected, intertwined. That's exactly the Lord is saying today. We don't know anything, my dear friends. Finally, I consider the task God gave to humans. He made everything fitting in its time, but He also set eternity in their hearts. Although they are not able to embrace the work of God from the beginning to the end. They have idea of the past and the future, but then we can't fathom and understand completely the entire gamut of His plan. No, we have only a segment of an idea. So all that we can do is to enjoy the moment. Look the situation as an onlooker, as a third party, and it will pass. Even your victory will pass, your defeat will pass. What is perpetual? What is everlasting? Who is Jesus to me? Jesus should be my foundation. Jesus should be my base, and He should be my all. Although the sky and moon fades away, earth shakes and breaks away, His love will never, never change. That's where the Lord is asking. The Lord is very clearly asking, but who do you say that I am? So today, ponder for a moment. Be silent and ask in our personal prayer. Jesus, who are you in my life? Who is Jesus to me? And He is my everything. He is my all. Jesus is my everything. How about you? Think about it and ponder upon that question the Lord is placing before you. Have a nice day. May God bless you all.